I've seen a few, and the first of which was Dragon Ball Z, and I love that series. So, yeah, and he has another question for me. How do you think Madara Uchiha will be stopped? Sorry if I mispronounce that. Basically, I didn't want to, give too much away in the message I sent, but, sorry, DJ, I don't really know what you're talking about there. I probably should have asked and seen, but yeah, I presume it's an anime thing, as you mentioned, icon in there. So yeah, sorry that I'm unable to answer that question, because, I'm not too sure what, that's from, and sorry if I mispronounced it. But yeah, there we go. So they're the only questions I have submitted. If you want to submit a question, add me on Facebook and send me a message, or post in the comments down below. So yeah, moving into the doctor list now. Just to be fair, I'm not going to include the Metacrisis Doctor. I'm not going to include the War Doctor, just because that one bit we got of him, you know, in that one episode. Well, I guess he was in more, but that was only brief. But what we saw of him, I can't really give an opinion, especially that we know that he's been around for longer than that. I mean, he's physically aged. So, and it won't obviously include the 12th Doctor, because we've only got brief moments of him. So, starting off at number 11, my least favourite Doctor, Peter Davison. Now, just to be clear, I don't hate any of the Doctors. I just dislike certain things about them. Usually there's a reason for me not liking them. Sometimes I just don't know why I don't like that specific Doctor. So yeah, Peter Davison is my least favourite, just because growing up he was the one I didn't know anything about, really. I'd only watched a handful of episodes, I think two episodes of his, maybe more, but they weren't that memorable for me. But the ones that stick out in my mind is, but I can clearly remember watching, Time Flight, which everyone knows is a horrible story, and The Five Doctors, which, let's say, Sfax. Most people would be watching that just because it's called The Five Doctors, not necessarily for The Fifth Doctor. But he does have some awesome stories. Caves of Androzani really stands out. A lot of people vote that one as the best. I don't know why. I wouldn't say it's the best. But yeah. So, Peter Davison. Yeah, so, next on my list, and this would have been a lot of other people's first Doctor, and that is the Ninth Doctor, Christopher Eccleston. I love his Doctor. It's just, he didn't stick around long enough for me to get, really attached to his Doctor. It's still sad when he goes, but yeah, and plus his views of the show, it seems wrong to put him up higher on my list just because of his actual views of the show. Not the Doctor, obviously, but Christopher Eccleston. Which is fair enough, he's entitled to his opinion, it's just it, but for me it would seem wrong to put him up higher than other actors who were committed to the show. Right, number 9, Colin Baker. Now, Colin Baker was utterly dogged on his time, with his time on the show. He was given a costume that sticks out in people's minds, and not in a good way. That's not a good thing. I don't mind his costume, but it's a bit out there and in your face. And his stories are pretty horrible. people say it's Patrick Troughton that makes that episode, and it's not. Colin is good too. There's some things about that episode that are sort of dodgy, but yeah. Attack of the Cybermen is a sort of mediocre, more than mediocre episode. I mean, more as in it's just a little bit higher than mediocre. But yeah, so, and of course, he was fired from the role, and it wasn't his fault. But yeah. So, moving on, and this one is going to get a lot of backlash and a lot of criticism, but I don't care. And that is David Tennant, the Tenth Doctor, because he only got good, in my opinion. And he got into a character that I sort of cared about in his last season. Because in season 2, him and Rose just utterly annoyed me. I know there's just something that's egotistical about them. Like, they go through time and, you know, I don't know. It just seems that it's weird. And then, of course, in series 3, yeah, the third series, he's just mopey about Rose and doesn't really take much notice of anyone else. But yeah, of course I'm blowing it out of proportion. I mean, it's not really like that, but it just annoys me. And series 4 is pretty cool. I think that's his best series. Sadly, of course, we get the mopey sort of bitch in End of Time and all of that, because, you know, he's the only one who sort of makes it seem like regeneration is equal to death. I mean, all the others just sort of deal with it, apart from probably Troughton, but, you know, he was put on trial, so, yeah, he had reason, but, yeah, he just seems to be really mopey about it, and, like, they try and justify it, but, yeah. Next, and I feel sort of bad about this, but William Hartnell, now he is amazing as the Doctor. It's just some of his stories can be utterly boring just because of the fact that some of them are historical stories, and that's, you know, can just be a tad boring. But, yeah. And next, I don't know what number we're up to now, I lost count. I would have to say Sylvester McCoy. Now, I think he is just amazing. He got a lot better in his last season, and his last two seasons. His first season is horrible. I haven't seen any episodes, but I've heard things, and yeah. But the later series, he started to develop into the Dark character, and that was really good. Unfortunately, the series was cancelled before we could see much of that, and that's why I think he's really underrated, because, yeah, his series was sort of horrible in some episodes, like the Candyman. But yeah, next, Patrick Troughton. Wow, some of the best episodes come from his era. Sadly, he's extremely, people just seem to brush him off because so many of his episodes are missing, and it's really sad. I mean, some of the ones we've got are real gems, Tomb of the Cybermen, that's my favourite Troughton episode, The War Games, but sadly his first episode's missing. Obviously, we got the discovery of Enemy of the World and The Web of Fear, which is fantastic. No, Web of Fear still has one episode missing, sadly. But, yeah, so I hope we can get those back, because it'd be just so good to see his first story and Evil of the Daleks and just describe how awesome he is. He was the action doctor. Yeah, really cool doctor. The velvet jackets, the Inverness capes, everything. He was just amazing. And that, of course, brings us to number one, who, of course, is Tom Baker. Again, he gave up 7 years of his life doing the show. That wraps that up.